We'll see some problems in this chapter, complex numbers. Right. See the first one. We have Z1, Z2. We need to find out Z1 minus Z2. We know that addition or subtraction, we need to add corresponding elements or subtract corresponding elements. That is, in this problem, Z1 is 2 comma minus 1, Z2 is 6 comma 3. They're asking to find out Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z2. So, corresponding elements we need to subtract. So, what are the corresponding elements here? 2, 6. Subtract it. 2 minus 6. If it is plus, plus. If it is minus, minus. If it is product, that is a different case. Minus 1, minus. So, the answer is minus 4, minus 4. Like that, we need to add of two complex numbers or subtract also two complex numbers. Remember, if you are adding the two complex numbers, just add corresponding elements. If you are subtracting the complex numbers, just subtract corresponding elements. Right? Second one is, they are asking additive inverse of root 3 comma 5. Just simple, they gave z equal to, let it be z root 3 comma 5. We need to find out additive inverse. Additive inverse of root 3 comma 5 is just simply take opposite sides. That is, here plus root 3 is there. What is the opposite sign of plus root 3? Minus root 3. And here plus 5 they give. So, what is the opposite sign of plus 5? It is minus 5. Okay. And we know that in additive property, if you add these two, we will get it additive identity. That is root 3 comma 5 plus of minus root 3 comma minus 5. If you add these two, that is corresponding elements we need to add. That is root 3 minus root 3 is 0. 5 minus 5 is 0. That is we are getting additive identity, right? So, just simple logic is in this one. Additive inverse means just write down the opposite signs of the given complex number. Right? They gave Z1, Z2. We need to find out Z1 by Z. Here Z1 is 6 comma 3, Z2 is 2 comma minus 1. They are asking to find out Z1 by Z. Right? Here Z1 is 6 comma 3. So, write in the form A plus I. That is 6 plus 3i. I am explaining now without using the formula. Z1 is 6 plus 3i. What will be Z2? 2 minus 1 into I. Right? Now, here, what is the denominator we have? 2 minus I. So, what is the conjugate of 2 minus I? That is a 2 plus I. Multiply and divide with conjugate of the denominator. Conjugate means we know that for imaginary part we need to take opposite sign. So here minus I is there. What is that opposite sign of minus I? Plus I. Right? Now here it is in general multiplication, multiply. 6 into 2, 2R plus 6 into I. Next one, 3I into 2, 6I, multiply 3I into I, 3I square. But we know that I square value is minus 1, so minus 3. By denominator, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. You can write as a square minus b square. That is a 2 square minus b value is here I square. Now, in this one, 12 minus 3, 9 plus 12i by 2 square is 4 and I square value is minus 1. So, it becomes plus 1. It is 5. So, this is a simplification of the Z1 minus Z1 by Z. Remember, if it is Z1 by Z2, denominator value multiplied and divided with the conjugate of the denominator, that is Z1 by Z2. Now, multiplicative inverse of 3 comma 4, this is the same as the sum third one. They are asking multiplicative inverse of 3 comma 4. Just now, multiplicative inverse is 1 by 3 comma 4. Just write on the reverse, 1 by, that is 1 by 3 plus 4, right? So, now simplify, multiply and divide with conjugate of the denominator. So, 3 minus 4i by, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, 3 square 9 and b square 4i square. it becomes 4 square I square, 16 I square, so plus 16. So 3 minus 4i by 25. This is the multiplicative inverse of 3 comma 4. Remember, multiplicative inverse of 3 comma 4 means we need to write it 1 by. Multiplicative means 1 by. Added inverse means just to change the signs. Simplify. Here, fifth observe here. Just they are asking simplified. Simplify means just multiply these two and write down in the form a plus I. Same as like. See here we multiplied, right? After multiplying in numerator, what is the value we are getting? 9 plus 12. So we need to write it like this. So if you do like this one, we will get the answer on this one. Just multiply. And here they are asking conjugate of 3 plus 4i. Just when we did conjugate. Conjugate of 3 plus 4i is what? Opposite sign of for the imaginary part. So here 3 plus 4i. Opposite sign for the imaginary part is here plus 4. Opposite will be minus 4. So the conjugate of 3 plus 4i is 3 minus 4. So these are the basic problems in this one. Sometimes they will give like this 2 plus I into 3i minus 4 by 1 plus I whole cube. Like this they will give and they will ask to simplify. What we need to do here, by seeing this you can get an idea that we can multiply. So multiply, and this is in the form of which model? A plus B whole cube. Expand it. In denominator we will get in the form some a plus ib model, right? So in numerator and denominator we will get like this one model, same as like this, multiply and divide with the conjugate of the denominator, simplified we will get it in the form.